Hello crafters, welcome to this video from MakerFlo Crafts on how to install the driver for your Epson sublimation printer. This video is intended for the Epson F170 sublimation printer, but it's the same for the 570. First, go to your internet browser and search for the Epson F170 or F570 driver. Then click on the link provided by Epson. The website should automatically detect your operating system once you've landed on the page. In case it does not, go ahead and pick the operating system you have on your computer from the drop-down list. Then go ahead and click on Drivers and download Drivers and Utility Combo Package. Then open up the file you just downloaded and follow the instructions on your screen. Go ahead and click OK from the pop-up, and you'll notice the installing has begun. Once the installing part has completed, you'll get another pop-up to select your desired language. Go ahead and click it and then click Next. Read through the terms and then go ahead and click Agree. After the installation has completed, you'll notice another step to go ahead and install the user's guide link. And then give it some time while it finishes downloading all the drivers and utilities. Make sure your printer is turned on, and then go ahead and click Next to proceed. Before clicking on this box, you'll also want to make sure the ink tanks are filled and that you did the charging process as described in the manual. After confirming this, check the box and click Next. Your printer will now show up here. Select it and click Next again. After the setup has completed, you can choose to register your Epson printer. Now this last bit of the setup can take a little while to complete. Go ahead and feel free to kick back and pat yourself on the back for a job well done so far. You're almost done. Once the setup has completed, the Express Product Registration screen will pop up. Go ahead and select Yes or No depending on if you want to register your product. Once you've made your choice, click Next, and then go ahead and let it finish downloading. Once the registration part is complete, it'll give you the option to plug in your information if you did want to go ahead and register your product. On that screen, go ahead and plug in all of your info, first and last name. Under the business use, go ahead and put if it's personal or business. And then for place of purchase, you'll want to make sure that you select the distributor or reseller option. After that's done and you have all of your information all filled out on the screen, you can go ahead and click Submit to continue. Congratulations! Now your printer is set up and ready to use. You can go to Printers and Scanners to double check that your computer recognizes your new Epson printer. From this page, you should be able to see your printer. It'll be labeled as SCF100 or SCF500. Now that everything's downloaded, we'll go ahead and test it out and do a test print. We're going to go ahead and pull up Adobe Illustrator to print out our first sublimation design. Keep in mind that you don't have to use Adobe specifically. You can use any design software you'd like to go ahead and complete your sublimation. Once you have the program up that you'd like to use, you'll want to either use the templates that you've been using or you can download them from the MakerFlo website. And then pull up that template and you can plug in the image you'd like to use in it. When you are ready to print, go ahead and go to the print option. You're going to look for your printer. It'll be labeled as SCF100 or SCF500 by default. Go ahead and select the correct printer from the menu, hit print, and enjoy. That concludes our video on how to install the driver for your Epson sublimation printer.